Hello and welcome to Red Live, and I hope everybody who is watching this is having an awesome day. Now, yesterday, a clip landed on social media of Makadzi working with both King Monada and Prince Benza on an upcoming song. Now, the title of the song is supposed to be Ganama, but as things are right now, it does seem that we are a long way from getting that hit song. Now, in the previous video, I kind of showed you King Monada's side of the story, but as the saying goes, there's always more than one side to a story. And in this video, I'm going to give you Makadzi's side of the story. Now, she does talk about how the song actually came to being, in that it was actually her song, and that when she went to studio, they actually worked on King Monada's song, and the agreement was that they would do another song for Makadzi. And that song seems to be this one in question, Ganama. And judging by the reception that it has gotten on social media, this could be a potential crossover song. So like I said, Makadzi also did a live video addressing King Monada's live video. Let me play that video for you guys real quick.
For more like live, Mo. Hello everyone. But what I mean face, do my lang like I wish and minja no. I don't know if I must speak in Venda or Tonga or Pedi or Kilobedu, because English is not my language, guys. I don't know. I don't have a translator, because I want to say something, and whatever I want to say now, I want everyone to understand me. So I don't know whether I must just use my English. Can I use my English, my broken English, or what? Please tell me, guys, can I use my broken English or what? Comment. Okay. I think Venda, Tonga, Kilobedu. Yeah, I want to clarify as well, you know, there is always two sides of the stories all the time, you understand? But at the end of the day, we must find a solution. I posted what I posted today, and then I went through comments. Some they were saying I'm not professional. You know, sometimes when you are angry, you don't have to, like, I want to know how to react to say, honey. I don't know what to know. I don't know what to know. I want to formula a reactor. I don't know what to know. I'm not trying to solve it. So, guys, I want to say something. I want to clarify you guys on something. Firstly, all I can say is that I saw Monada, he was live on his Facebook page. Firstly, what I can talk about, I want to talk about his facial expression. His facial expression, yoba ya mutu anokunye gofila tungu, ashko haida wujine aba zonenga ngomu. Before I can even go to today's situation, I want to take you back, guys. Back then. Back then, for those who used to follow my music and everything, my collaborations with King Monada. For sure, you guys, you know the songs which I'm going to talk about today. We recorded the song like Bo Vuan Nim Fare Fare, Bo Ntakuse, Bo Kimutona Kavenda. Like, we did a lot of songs with Monada. Bo Ngangaya Ngaya Kona, right? On those songs, all of those songs which I'm talking about right now, I am the one who came with the idea. All the time when I get to the studio with King Monada, I come up with the idea of the song. I come up with the melody of the song. What Monada will do is to come and add after what I did, you get my point. By that time, I didn't have a voice or a power to talk about it because people will say, maybe I'm a bitter. But it was not sitting well with me. For me, doing a song with Monada today, tomorrow the song, without even me knowing, I will only see a song on Facebook written, King Monada featuring Makhazi, without even my concern. I will only see that song maybe on Facebook or on YouTube. And that song, mind you, I'm the one who wrote it. I did everything on it, but I will just see the song, a song on YouTube. You get my point. So by that time, I didn't say anything. I kept quiet. And you know, even the recording sessions, they were very much bad. Munada used to treat me like a dog. I used to go to his studio and skip exams because of him. He will say, wait, we'll record tomorrow, just because of how I've been, I knew what I wanted in this game. I was patient, you understand? I was like, because of, I knew exactly what I wanted. I wanted to be here where I am today. So now I'm here where I am today. I will never allow anyone to come and use my talent like a shapist, like what Munada want to do. You get my point? So I was talking about the previous lifestyle of Munada, which you guys, you didn't know. Munada used to treat me like a dog. But now I stood up. I didn't even care whether Munada is not working at my record label or what. I wanted to work with him because the only thing that I wanted from Munada was his talent and us to unite as Limpopo artists. But Munada, he always acts smart when it comes to artists. He always wants to use people all the time. You get my point? So let's come on this issue for this song, which is trending today. What happened is 2 weeks ago, King Munada sent me a song. That song, Vibe is Impossible. I listened to the song. I went to Mr. Brown's studio. And then instead of me putting that verse, I was like, ish, you know, sometimes when you are listening to a song, but you're not getting it right, sometimes you can feel, you know, it needs, maybe if I'm with that person in the same studio, maybe utakhonon tusha gore how what's happening, because it's his song, you get my point. So, and then it's fine. I recorded that verse. I didn't feel it like that for that song, Impossible. Not this one. I'm talking about his song, not the one I want to talk about now. Okay, it's fine. On Saturday, I went to Suzanini. I was performing at Village. And then I called Munada. I got a puncher, actually. I called Munada. I was like, do you have a tire? Or, you know, a mobile extension tire. Munada came and helped me with the tire. And then by that time, because of Kimo Zanini, I was like, you know what? Instead of you traveling to Joburg, I have the WhatsApp he's saying he wants to show you. Now I have WhatsApp from day one when he approached me. He even posted on Facebook. Remember, his followers will tell me if I'm wrong. He posted on Facebook. He went live on Facebook 2 weeks ago playing an Impossible song. He said he wants Makhazi. That was his song. You get my point? That's the song I'm talking about. Impossible song, which he said he wants me to be part of it. Okay. I went to Zanini. Yes, he came and helped me. And then I was like, okay, it's fun because I'm around Zanini. Let's go to your studio so that I can record that song, at least cause Kimo, cause what? The vocals, you that song Impossible. I was with Greya, but now I'm here. I don't mind to re-record my verse. You get my point. It happened that I was with Prince Benza and my crew. We went to Munada's house. The reason why I went there to Munada's house is because of I wanted to put my verse on his song. You get my point? On my WhatsApp, I even mentioned it. I even told Munada that I prefer us making two songs. You take one song, I take one song. You get my point? I went to Munada's studio. I went there. I recorded. Actually, before I can even record, because of Munada knew that I want a beat from him. It's exchange. You give me a song, I give you a song. That's how it works. You get my point? When I get to Munada's studio, Munada did a beat. That beat, he did it with other guys. I don't know, but like I got them, go studio, some other. And then that beat, I didn't even sing on top of that beat. That's the beat which Munada was supposed to give me, to sing on top of that beat. For Munada to have two songs and choose one. You get my point? Prince Benza had to do a beat for me. This one, Yaganama. He did a bit for me just because of, Monada said you want to try my style. How can you want to try my style whereas you want to feature me? On my style, I feature you. You get my point. It's fine. Benda did a bit just because of, I knew that Benda is doing a bit for me. Because already I did a song for Monada. Meaning this is my song. I came up with the idea. I wrote a song. I composed everything. I was like, Monada, please, because of Batu. They are used to Rina or Haridia collaboration. You are the one who starts singing. I'm not saying Monada composed the song. Monada, I'm the one who said Monada must sing first. For my voice, because I want to come higher. Urikono correspond. You get my point? And then Monada recorded a song, his part. And then I came up with my part. And remember, I'm saying I composed the song. I came up with a melody when Benza is busy doing the beat. The thing he held Benza to do a beat, he's lying. That facial expression of Monada, he's just trying to fool you. You know, I don't want to talk about a lot of things. Because a lot of people, they used to complain about Monada. They will just come and say about their personal issues, like tomorrow or whenever. Because I don't want to talk about people's names. But that facial expression of Monada is to fool you guys, because he used to rob people. He used to manipulate people all the time to believe that he's a good person. You get my point? Not saying Uri. Not to me now, I think he's a good person, because he doesn't want to give me the credit I deserve. I wrote a song. I came up with a melody, and then on top, you didn't produce the beat. How are you owning a song whereas you didn't compose a song? You didn't come up with a melody. Then what you did is only to put a verse, and then now you want to own a song because of, you see people. I didn't tell you guys to leave. You guys were enjoying the music, which is good. You guys were hacking Matorokisi on a piano song. It's not a problem. That's what you are deciding. You get my point? That's my song. Monada, if you want to release that song, if I say, now I've been used. I can't allow him to use me until I die. I'm saying Monada must remove my voice if you want to release that song. He must remove my voice, my verse, and he must not use Prince Benza's beat, because I'm the one who asked Prince Benza to do a beat for me. That's it. Bye-bye.
So yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is Makhadzi's side of the story. I don't know what you guys think of this. You know, it's kind of taking some twists and turns. Personally, I do hope that the artists do resolve their differences and give us some good music. And as always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Real Live if you haven't, and binge watch my previous videos.